Students, let us recall what we have learned in the earlier video. We have already learned about heavenly bodies. What do you mean by heavenly bodies? Heavenly bodies include stars, planets, moon, asteroids, dwarf planets, etc. What is the difference between stars and planets? Stars have their own light, but planets do not have their own light. Stars twinkle, but planets do not twinkle. Example for star, sun. Example for planets, Earth, Jupiter, Saturn, etc. Satellites. What do you mean by satellites? Satellites revolve around the planets and also they revolve around the sun. Dwarf planet. Pluto is an example of dwarf planet. Asteroids. Asteroids means between Mars and Jupiter there is a band of objects which revolve around the sun and they are called asteroids. Now let us learn about something more about this chapter. Students, you might have seen the leaves, flowers, fruits fall from a tree. Rocks that come loose from a hillside or rain falling from the sky. What do you understand from these? Means the objects fall on the earth. Why do these objects fall on the earth? Here is an answer. All heavenly bodies exert a force of attraction or pull one another. Heavenly bodies, you know, stars, planets, asteroids, etc. They pull one another. And this force is called the force of gravity. Gravity means the force that attracts a body towards the center of the earth or towards any other physical body. Means if you consider earth, it is regarding to earth or any other heavenly body, may be star or planets or satellites, etc. The sun exerts a gravitational pull. Means what? Gravitational pull. A forceful attraction or movement towards something. Movement towards something. Whereas the tendency of the planets is to move away from the sun. For example, if you consider this ball as a planet and its tendency is to move away from the sun. But sun also exerts gravitational force. The gravitational force depends upon the size of the object. Gravitational force depends upon the size of the object. For example, if you look at this picture, here, sun is bigger in size than other planets. So, naturally, sun has more gravitational force than the other planets. So, it has more power to attract the planets. So, these planets revolve around the sun. In the same way, satellites revolve around their planets. Now I am going to tell you about what is revolution and what is rotation. If you consider this bindi, if I turn this like this and afterwards again it completes this much movement around itself. And this moment is called rotation. And while rotating itself, it revolves, if it revolves around the other objects, and then it is known as revolution. Now a question comes, why do all objects remain on the earth? The answer is, due to the earth's gravity, due to the Earth's gravity means force of attraction. All things on the earth remain on it. इवन इफ वी थ्रो समथिंग अपवर्ड्स विद ग्रेट फोर्स इट फाइनली फॉल्स डाउन ऑन द ग्राउंड इट फाइनली फॉल्स डाउन ऑन द ग्राउंड Now let us see a new word, space. What is the meaning of space? Space means the emptiness between and beyond the stars and planets is called space or outer space. See this picture now. Here in this diagram, here you can see here is the sun, here Jupiter, Saturn and other planets are there. Between these planets and sun there is empty space and this is called what we call space, emptiness between the two objects. People have always been curious means what, eager to know about the heavenly bodies in the sky. They have always wanted to reach them. However, to send some object from the earth into space, there must be given power against the force of gravity. Rocket technology or space launch technology is used for that purpose. You might have used Diwali firecrackers or other firecrackers. It is packed with explosives. Explosives means they explode or burst when we put fire. The explosives burn rapidly and produce a lot of energy. The design of the rocket is such that the firecracker is pushed in a certain direction at a great speed. In this picture you can see the space launch using a rocket. Here see, these are rockets. What is meant by spacecraft? Spacecraft means a vehicle used for traveling in space. Just as we use vehicle, bus, car, jeep, train, etc. So spacecraft is a vehicle which is used for traveling in space. A tremendous quantity of fuel is burnt in rockets so that spacecraft weighing thousands of tons can be launched into space. See here, tremendous means very large quantity of fuel. Fuel means what? The thing which is used for burning and which is used to produce energy. For example, wood, coal, petrol, diesel, kerosene, etc. The fuel is burnt in rockets so that spacecraft weighing thousands of tons can be launched into space. What is meant by ton? 1 ton means how many kg? 1000 kg. You can imagine how much weight does it carry. In the 20th century, a few countries of the world developed space technology and sent hundreds of spacecraft into space. Our country is well known for the development of its space launch technology. Some spacecraft remain in space, some are brought back to Earth, while some land on other planets or satellites. In some missions, scientists also travel in the spacecraft. They are called astronauts. Astronauts means a person who is trained to travel in space. Indian astronaut Rakesh Sharma became the first Indian astronaut to go into the space in 1984. He spent 8 days. How many days? 8 days on a space station for a joint mission of the ISRO and the Soviet Intercosmos. Seeing India from space, he said that it looked sare jahan se acha. Do you know India's space mission? You might have heard about Chandrayaan in TV channels. On 22 October 2008, the Indian Space Research Organization, ISRO, what is the full form of ISRO? Indian Space Research Organization, launched a spacecraft to the moon. Moon is our satellite, natural satellite. The mission is known as Chandrayaan. The mission is known as Chandrayaan. Here, what is the meaning of mission? A determination to do something. Reaching the moon is not an easy task. It needs firm determination. It needs a lot of teamwork and a lot of money also. So we call that as mission. Mangalyaan. Mangalyaan is another important Indian space mission. It is known as MOM. What is the full form of MOM? Mars Orbit Mission. It was launched on 5th November 2013. It was started on 5th November 2013. It got established in an orbit. Orbit means what? The path along which a satellite or a planet revolves. It got established in an orbit around the planet Mars on 24 September 2014. Means the mission was Mars Orbit Mission was started on 5th November 2013 and completed on 24th September 2014. ISRO achieved this feat in its first attempt. Means in first many countries of the world made many attempts and afterwards they got succeeded in that work, that mission, but our country succeeded it in its first attempt. We should be proud of it. Both these missions are unmanned. Unmanned means what? No man was sent in that spacecraft. That is, there were no people on board these spacecraft. The objective means what? The main intention of the missions is a deeper study of the moon and Mars. To study, detailed study of moon and Mars, these spacecraft have been sent. Here you can see the pictures of Mangalyaan. A photograph of the region around India. See, you will see here, region around India, taken by Mangalyaan.